day ticket carp fishing. I love it. I think the first thing is they're open access. You can fish lots of different lakes, and I love to fish like all over the place, really, here, there and everywhere. Whatever's fishing well, I'll quite happily go there. They hold a lot of fish. Now, I don't get to go fishing all the time. Sometimes I'm lucky enough to go 2 days a week, so I want to go somewhere where I can get bites and a chance of a decent fish. So day tickets generally hold a decent quantity of fish, and most of them that I fish hold a good number of 30s, 40s, and some of which also hold 50s, so ticks every box. I don't purposely go and say I am going to target this specific fish and do this to catch the fish. I just go fishing to get lots of bites. Whatever comes along is welcome, but obviously on the long term, I know that the more bites I get, the more chance I've got of catching the big one. So it's a numbers game, really. I just go fishing to get bites, and anything bigger fish is just a bonus for me, really. My top few notable day ticket captures, I've had so many, it would be very, very hard to sort of nail it down, but probably the big plated at St John's, that's one that everybody would love to get their hands on. So I bumped into that in 2009, so that was a nice one. Dave out of Bluebell, it was just colossal at £55.12. You know, you're never going to forget that day for the rest of my life. That was just awesome. And I've had a couple of trips to Lynch Hill Christchurch, where on three separate occasions I've had a brace of 40s. And one of the occasions, at the time, I had my PB common and my PB mirror, which was £41 common and £45 mirror, within 4 hours of each other one night in winter. So again, that one's one that stands out big time. One of the most important aspects of day ticket carping is getting in the right area and getting on the fish. The best way to do it is just to simply watch the water. If you can see fish showing, you've got to get on them. It's not always as easy as that, because they can be quite busy at times, but you just got to get as close as possible. You see a lot of people, they just want to fish the so-called best swims in the known hot spots in that, but they're next to useless if the fish aren't in front of them. So you just got to keep your eyes peeled and get on the fish. And that can change throughout the year, throughout a session even. The fish move around a hell of a lot. There's loads of fish in here in a lot of the day ticket waters, and they really can be anywhere. You know, there are no rules. The fish don't always sit in the hot spots. You just got to find fish and get on them, and that is the biggest thing that I can offer in carp fishing. So once you've found your swim, and once you've got in your swim, the next thing really to do is to find a spot to fish. Now, all day ticket waters are a little bit different, and I tend to categorise them into sort of two different types. You've got weedy ones and you've got non-weedy ones. I'll start with the non-weedy type of lake. Generally, if I've got a lake that's got no weed in, and you've got a mixture of gravel, silt areas, and in my opinion, it doesn't matter what you're fishing on. It doesn't matter if you're on gravel, if you're on silt. The biggest thing is getting your bait as close to fish as you can get. So if you see fish showing and it's completely clear out there, I will have a quick check, Chuck, just to make sure it's nice and smooth. And it doesn't matter if it's silt or gravel. If I see fish in an area, I'll clip up to it and put some bait in. And as long as I'm fishing accurately where the fish are and give them a decent quality bait that they want to eat, I know that there's every chance that I'm going to catch them. The second type of lake that I talk about is if it's quite a weedy lake. Now, it's completely different on a weedy lake as it would be to a lake that has got no weed in at all. So to start with, it's so important on a weedy lake to find the right spot. And generally, I try and find as clear a spot as I can find. A lot of the time it will be gravel, because of in the silt the weed grows a lot better, and where you've got gravel areas, generally the weed doesn't grow on top of it. So I do tend to look for the clearest possible spots, and I tend to find that if you put bait in on those clear spots, it's easier to present a bait, and the fish just seem to love to feed a lot easier on the clearer areas, and that's what I'll always be looking for. So you really need to be careful with your plumbing and fish really accurately to find the spots and then to bait up and get on them. once you've got your watercraft sorted and you found the fish, you've got on them, you found the perfect spot to put some bait in, you then got to choose exactly what bait to use. And I've got to admit, I tend to keep it fairly simple. I've got a day ticket mix that seems to work wherever I go. Now, to start off with, I use three key main components, and you can probably pick them out there quite easily: sweet corn, hemp, and 10 mil boilies. Recently, I've been using the tuna. It's like a real fishy, stinky bait, and it seems to be working quite well. But to be honest, you can add all sorts to the mix just to customize it, and I'd probably suggest you do that, because a lot of people are on this type of mix now. So in recent times, I've been using little 2mm tuna pellets as well, just to give it extra bit of a boost. And another interesting product that I've been using quite a bit through the testing period and is actually out now is the krill micromass. And you can see it is the light, sort of light pinkish in color, and it leaks off. And I tell you, that stuff, it stinks, but in a moorish kind of way. It really, really does add a different dimension to my spod mix. And it's sort of all, lots of odd little shapes and small bits and pieces, and it just keeps the carp rooting round for ages. But like I said, three main key components, and then just try and do something a little bit different just to give yourself the edge over the bloke next door. I've never really been one for overcomplicated rigs. I'm a great believer that if you can get the right spot, get them feeding, any sort of half decent, well presented rig, and you're going to catch the carp. But for the last 3 years, I've been using sort of my version of the hinge stiff rig. And it again, is a rig that works for me. I've caught loads of fish on it. There's plenty of other rigs out there that will catch, but this is just the one that I have chosen for a few various little reasons. So to start with, I've got a sort of semi-stiff sort of braided hook link. So that's bulletproof. That's never going to snap, never going to let me down. And I actually use a little short ready tied chod rig on the end to give it the hinge stiff rig. So you always want to fish it with a pop up, so it just sits just off the deck, just like that. And a couple of the key advantages of that are, no matter what you're sort of fishing over, whether there's a little bit of light weed or debris, your hook bait's just off the deck all the time. The other thing with the stiffness of the material, it always kicks it away from the lead, so it's almost impossible for this rig to tangle. The stiffness of the boom section here as well, that kicks it out away from the lead as well, so it's completely tangle proof really. Also, if a fish was to suck the hook bait up and then spit it back out again, the rig's always going to reset itself. So with this rig, I'm quite happy to cast it out there, or cast three of them out there, and leave it for a longer period of time. When it comes to hook baits for fishing over the mix, I've got three rods on the spot most of the time. So sometimes I might fish three the same, but normally I'll start with at least two different hook baits, sometimes three. Recently, I've been using a little white pop-up, which kind of goes against what I have been fishing in the last few years, because I've always really tried to match my hook baits to what I'm putting out. And for the most part, 10 millers, sweet corn is figures heavily in the mix. So I'm normally fishing a 10 mil pop-up with a little bit of yellow corn. But recently I've had great success going against that and fishing a completely different hook bait over the top of the mix. So I think the white one is the one I've been catching on, and it stinks. It's one of the tuna ones that really, really is potent. But it's something a little bit different that really stands out. And I've had a couple of 30s on it on this trip. So it's always worth, you've got three chances, you've got three rigs on a spot. Why not have three different hook baits and see which one catches the most? You know, you'll soon learn from it.
Oh dear, there we go. This is why I absolutely love day ticket carp fishing. It's my first night of the year on Manor Farm on the linear complex, and I've only gone and bagged this chunk of a mirror. Nice linear, 32.5 pounds. Just goes to show, if you can get your day ticket tactics right, you can catch plenty of fish as stunning as this.